to a point, share the wealth. The people who are preparing the food for you, just kind of let them know that they're a little bit more conscious. Just be conscious of your salt content, your salt intake. We tend to like a lot of salt things when it comes to chips and things of that nature, nuts, but be very conscious of what you're taking in. I know, like I said, a lot of people are not cooking right now, but these are things you can share and move on and be a lot more conscious of as you move forward, because at some point you will be cooking. I don't think mom and dad can prepare your food, your meals for help. Okay. Sweetness. Okay. You take a lot if you're coffee drinkers, if you're tea drinkers, you tend to use the typical white sugar, sometimes brown sugar, but there are other options. We use equal, we use what's the other one that comes in a little pink packet?
Sweet and low.
Right. Those type of things are pretty damaging because they're processed in the warehouse, all right? If you go with stevia, or there's another thing out there called Truvia. Those are plant-based sweeteners. People say they have that bad aftertaste, but like anything else you do, like when you do it enough times, you get used to what it has to offer, and you make the adjustment. And I remember, like I said earlier, when we're talking about this journey of getting fit, getting healthy, it's about change. It's about doing some different things to get some different results. So if you're truly trying to lose weight, get healthy, get fit, that means doing some things a little bit differently than the way we're doing them today. Else, you're not really gonna reach your goal. Think about why you're here at school, right? You guys are after something, whatever that goal is, whatever that degree is. In order to get it, you're gonna have to do some different things in order to get to that goal so you can move on to higher things, to better things. Same thing with fitness, same thing with health. To get some different results, you gotta do some different things. And that's where food comes and plays a big part. A lot of people tell you, hey, just work out, go to the gym. You're not putting the right food in your body, you will not get the level of fitness that you truly seek. We've talked to liquids, sure, tea, herbal teas, nothing's better than water. Anybody tell me right now how many calories in a cup of water?
Zero.
There you go. All right. But it's what hydrates, it's what feeds the body. It hydrates the body, keeps things flowing. Okay? Uncomfortable, we don't want to get up and go to the bathroom in 2 minutes, but in a way, that's kind of what we want. That's how we know things are happening, okay? The goal is usually you want to drink, get in at least 96 ounces of water a day, whenever possible, all right? But you have to balance that with food, okay? It's very important, right? It keeps the body hydrated. It keeps your organs hydrated. That's what your body, the body is made up of 85% water, okay? So it's very important that we have that water intake. Not just when we're thirsty, but throughout the day, continue to do that. And I tend to find that if you have a bottle of water on your desk or in front of you, there's more of a tendency to drink if you have it there. But if you only get up and do it when you're thirsty, then it's not gonna be enough to serve over the course of the day. So when you go shopping and you start looking for things, you start becoming more conscious of foods, a list like this is a place to start. And start with the things that you truly enjoy. Right? It's okay, because this list, 99% of the things on this list are not going to hurt you, they will only help you. But the important thing is to know that they will serve you and know how to prepare them, especially when it comes to your meats, the proteins, the vegetables, things of that nature. Know how to prepare them is what's going to, what makes a difference. We tend to want to drop everything in frying pan with a whole lot of grease. So it's knowing how to use olive oil as opposed to using Wesson and Crisco, some of the things that we tend to use. Knowing how to put things in a broiler and prepare them that way. Knowing how to steam vegetables. And those are things that you guys, as you progress and start preparing a lot of your own meals, will become more aware of. Again, we talk about, people have this question of, we talked about getting fit and healthy. What pills can I take? What supplements can I take? There's this mentality that, hey, if I just take this pill or that pill, I'll lose 30 pounds. You see all the things, all the advertisement TV about, hey, lose weight, take this pill, you'll lose 3 pounds in 30 days. Not true. Not true at all. A multivitamin is very important. Multivitamins taking one a day type of things, type of vitamins, whether it be men or women, supplement to your food on a regular basis, okay? So there's no one pill you can take that's going to make you look like Arnold Schwarzenegger. It look like that fashion model that you see on the cover of the magazines. We're talking about healthy eating, the nutrition, combined with the consistent exercise. So vitamins are supplemental. They're an add-on to whatever you should be eating on a regular basis. Okay. Give me a breakdown. The three different types of foods, similar to the list that we talked about earlier. We talked about proteins and muscle builders, chicken, turkey, salmon, eggs, Greek yogurt, and I tend to lean toward non-fat Greek yogurt, tuna, any kind of white fish, which might be tilapia, or cod. Give me another white fish. There's another white fish out there. Tilapia, cod.
Flounder.
Flounder. Thank you. Lean grass-fed red meat, whey protein powder, and cottage cheese. Again, all good options. Be very conscious. Just know that they're out there, and that they're for you. Carbs, sweet potato, brown rice, rolled oats, or just in simple terms, oatmeal. Beans, quinoa, apples, berries, blueberries, blackberries, strawberries, buckwheat, whole grain tortilla, or it just whole grain bread, or whole wheat bread, or whole grain bread. Those both serve you in a very good way. Understand these are all foods that the body will process normally if taken in properly, if taken in the proper portions. Again, with your healthy fats, almonds, coconut oil is another thing you can actually prepare your food in. Avocados, flaxseed, chia seeds, pecans, olive oil, these are all things. Peanut butter, almond butter, these are all good, healthy options that the body will normally digest and take in. Again, coming back to portion controls, how much of each you should be eating on a regular basis. Okay. The restaurant menu. You sit down, when you go to the restaurant, you tend to eat out. These are the type of things you need to keep in mind when you place that order with the waitress or waiter. Understand that they are there to serve you, and you get to pick and choose. If you're on a healthy path to getting, if you're on a path of getting healthy, getting fit, being the best version of yourself, you have to make sure that the waiter or waitress or the restaurant as a whole is serving you in such a way that caters to your lifestyle. Okay? The type of things on the left are the things you need to kind of stay away from. Foods that are fried, that have a lot of batter, butter, cream, crispy or crunchy, if you will, cheesy, things that are thick, breaded, that's smothered with glaze or gravy, and things of that nature are high in calories, clog your arteries, and we're talking about a whole lot of other health issues that will follow with those type of choices. So if you lean toward the right side of the menu, we're talking about thinking of broiled, steamed, blackened, baked, roasted, light, fresh, grilled, or sautéed. Those things, low calorie, they do not alter the actual state of the food. And they don't add those, they don't put on those extra calories that are not going to serve you. We have things we call it, that we call empty calories. Calories that are deficient to the body, they don't serve you. They taste good going down, but in the long run, they do not serve you. So it's very important that when you go to the restaurant, especially, you make the type of decision that's going to serve you from a healthy standpoint, and that's going to put you on the road towards your fitness goal. Okay, eat is not that. I want to put a little something out there for you to get an idea of where you're at. did not dare the type of choices that you may be making today. And understand that not only this is a judgment-free zone, you may choose the wrong answer, but it's okay. This is all about learning, okay? Okay, first question. First stage, I should say. Tim needs to start his day out with a healthy breakfast, but oh no, he only has Cheerios and Rice Krispies. Which one do you think is healthier?
Cheerios.
Okay. In this case, it is Cheerios, because I mean, just from a calorie standpoint, 100 calories less than the other option. So, again, that goes back to flipping over those boxes, those containers, and knowing exactly what the calorie counts are. Okay, next one. Now he decides he wants a drink to go. Which one is healthier? The Minute Maid apple juice or the Welch's mixed berry?
Welch's.
Okay. Again, Welch's is only 70 calories. It has a mix of blue, black, and raspberries, whereas Minute Maid has 140 calories. Again, flipping that label over. Okay, now, as time rolls by, Doc decides he wants to go to Wendy's. Of course, he only has two options. Which one should he pick? Single burger with everything or the chicken club?
Chicken club.
I thought the same thing, but in this case, not the case. I thought going with the chicken club, but this time, a single burger has 110 calorie difference and 200 milligrams of sodium. See, again, sometimes it's calories, but it's some of those other things that we talked about earlier, the sodium, the cholesterol that's contained. Take a look at some of those things, it'll kind of give you an idea of what kind of choices you make. But trust me, I made the wrong decision also when I first looked at this place. Okay, I don't have all the answers. Four. Now he's starting to get hungry again, so he decides he wants a snack. He can't decide whether or not he wants a Twix, Skittles, Reese's, or Kit Kat? I'm hitting a few things now. I automatically picked the Reese's because I thought about the peanut butter content, because it's healthy. Kit Kat? Okay, chooses Twix. Or Skittles. Skittles, did you like Skittles or what? Well, in this case, Kit Kat.
Yes.
It only has 220 calories, while the others have a big difference in terms of grams, fat, and sugar. So again, it goes back to that whole list. Not just the calories, but the sodium, the cholesterol, the fat content, the sugar content. Scan down that list and make a decision based on that. And I guess we're talking to a guy who has a thing for sugar. So all of these options look great. And I probably didn't lean towards Skittles because that's just my thing. But I for one thought Reese's because it had that peanut butter content. But if you don't know what we don't know until we flip that label over and really take a look. Okay, last question. Sorry. Okay, for dinner, his mom tells him that they're going to order pizza tonight, but Tim tells his mom about the healthy crusades all day. So his mom decides to try and find a healthy pizza. Which one do you think he's more healthy? Mm-hmm. Crunchy, thin crust, or the classic hand toss?
Thin crust.
Crunchy thin has 260 calories, while the other one has twice as much. Okay? Thick crust, you think about all the carbs and the bread and all the stuff that goes with it. But it's a calorie count. And with pizza, it's a little difficult because if we go to Pizza Hut or go to Domino's or our favorite pizza place, it's pretty much made for you. So there's no label to really flip over. But now that you have this little bit of information, you can make a better decision when it comes to thin crust or crunchy or thick crust. knowing that the calorie count is a little bit different. So again, the learning never stops. And if you're the type of person who likes to order pizza from the little supermarket frozen, if you will, those things will have a breakdown of the different type of calorie count, the fat content, the sugar, the salt. So you can make some conscious decisions about what you're gonna take in. So it's all a matter of just understanding exactly what you're taking in, flipping those boxes, those containers over, and understanding exactly what the contents are before you make a decision. What I'll do is, before you leave, I'll share all the answers and the explanations with you so you can kind of take that with you. And stay within a certain range of where you are right now, the minimum of 3 times a week and 30 minutes a day at the minimum as far as working out stuff. But when I train my clients, we have 30 minute sessions and I push them really hard because if they're only seeing me once a week, there's a tendency for them to only work out when they're with me. So we go hard, you know, for 30 to 35 minutes. If I have clients who are more consistent and who are accountable to themselves and will go home and work out on their own, then we do a hard 30 minutes, but they'll go home and do 2 or 3 sessions by themselves throughout the week. And the rest is just as important. Okay. Got a little challenge for y'all. As you know, we all have jobs, or we all at school. So we change our desk and they're in it, and we have to make a conscious effort to be active. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this time, everybody on their feet for a little bit. We're just going to do some stretching. All right? Nothing aggressive. I'm not going to ask you to move anything. You're not going to move your chairs. All we need you to do is just kind of get going. All right? So all I ask you to do for the next couple of minutes, okay, is just kind of give each other some space so we don't knock each other out. Okay? And all I'm asking you to do is just kind of stretch the upper body. Alright? Arms up, just kind of stretch those shoulders. Okay? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, lower body. Just 5 knees. Nothing aggressive. Nothing too fast. This is something. Get that lower half activated, all right? We're gonna get the blood going. You're gonna say how to get your heart rate going, but we're gonna get the blood going. All right, like I said, we all tend to nail to our desk. Unless we have a job or a task where we have to get up, we don't get up. Okay, stretch on your toes. Bring it down. Okay, one more time, stretch. Now just kind of kick back. Instead of lifting up, kick back. Those knees back a little bit. Those quads activate a little bit. And these are things that you can do during your day. Just get the blood going. Okay? You can all have a seat now. And the importance of this type of thing at hand is just to kind of get the blood going. We all sometimes tend to lead very sedentary lifestyles. Sit all day. You get up and you have to go to the restroom. We get up, we want to get something to eat, but we don't get up. Otherwise, we just stay. sitting there for our desk.
Let me ask you a question.
You. During the day, how many meals a day do you eat? Generally. Three? So you get them in breakfast, lunch, dinner. Good. How about you, sir? Ma'am?
One.
One. What meal is that?
Lunch. I mean, supper.
So later in the day. Mm-hmm. Okay. And that's okay, you know, because there are ways of working around that. So, and let me ask you, the type of work that you do during that, does it keep you stationary at your desk?
Mm-hmm. You're on the arm.
So, oh, you're on your feet all the time. Okay, so you have to be, I'm thinking, you have to make a conscious effort to eat because of the type of job that you have. Why do you wait so long to eat? I mean, what hours are you? Is it just the hours, or you just eat when you're hungry, or?
I don't have an appetite. I don't have work stuff, so I don't have an appetite.
Okay, and that's okay, and I hear that a lot. But remember, and this is not just to you, to all of us, you should not just be eating when you're hungry, okay? The body needs nourishment. You gotta give it what it needs. Because if not, it's like kind of like trying to drive your car on minimal gas. At some point, it's gonna run out. The car will tell you that you need gas. That light comes on, you'll start to feel a little difference in the car. Your body's the same way. If you don't get those meals in, you're gonna kind of stay in a sluggish, tired, run-down kind of state, and that can lead to some very serious health issues. So what you need to do is don't deprive yourself. Even if you're on a weight loss journey, do not skip meals. That's the misconception that we have all the time, that if I want to lose weight, I'm just not gonna eat. Quite the opposite, because if you skip meals and you're only eating once or twice a day, or you're not eating often enough, the body doesn't know what's going on. And when it does, you do feed it, it just holds on to it, and it holds on to it as fat. And that's not what you want. We're trying to lose weight, and we're trying to get fit, we're trying to be the best version of ourselves. So it's very important that we get to a point where we're eating three meals a day. But if you're hungry in between, just number one, make good choices with those three meals, but fresh fruit, all right, as opposed to chips and cookies. In between meals are just as important. It keeps the metabolism going. It keeps the body churning. Water throughout the day is very important. All right. As uncomfortable as it is to have to get up and go to the bathroom, all right, you don't feel like doing that all day. It is a good thing. It just shows that the body is functioning the way it's supposed to. But you gotta feed. Do not skip meals, because that is as big a culprit for weight gain as it is overeating. Until the day we eat too much and we don't get active, we're gonna gain weight. Yes. But if we under-eat, the mark generally is 1,200 calories a day that you should be taking it at a minimum. Because anything less than that is considered starvation, and you're putting your body through a lot of changes. So it's very important, and what we're going to talk about later is meal planning and prepping, and knowing that having the food, the access on a regular basis, even if it's fresh fruit, I'd rather you have fresh fruit as opposed to having nothing. Okay, it's very important. Okay, weight loss. Okay, we'll talk about the principles of weight loss, some of the bad diets that you might have heard about, holiday eating, Thanksgiving is right upon us. I got a friend named Angela Hudson who's done some amazing things with fitness. Portion control, the scale, we don't want to be living by the scale. The scale is what our measure is to see if we're losing weight, if we're getting healthier. But we don't want to be driven by the scale. The lifestyle, we'll talk about maybe weight loss competition, and we'll talk about some other questions that you may have. Okay, healthy weight loss. Basically, when we talk about healthy weight loss, we're talking about what we talked about earlier. We're talking about eating three squares a day, carbs, proteins, healthy fats. Basically, your vegetables, your protein from meat, and your fibrous carbs. We talk about from green vegetables in general. That's your balance. That should be your mark. In between, we talk about fresh fruit, maybe yogurt, things of that nature, things that give you some energy in those in-between times of your day. When it comes to a lot of these diets, see advertised on TV, you may see books in the shelves, lose 10 pounds in 10 days. I think we've all seen some of those things. Very misleading. Number one, there's a reason why they say lose 10 pounds in 10 days, because that's the shelf life. Anytime after that 10-day period or that 30-day period, thank you, after that 30-day period, the so-called diet that they offer is not nearly as effective. Okay? It's not going to serve you the way having a healthy lifestyle where you're eating 3 squares a day and having those snacks that you need, they're not going to serve you, because after a while, there's a failure rate that just kind of goes, it's not nearly as effective, and it's not sustainable, because a lot of these things have you eating at all kind of odd intervals of the day, to the point where you're actually going hungry, you're putting yourself through something where you're not comfortable. It may have you deficient on water, it may have you deficient on certain nutrients that you just need to function. So it's very important that when you see those books, when you see those commercials, just think in terms of, is this really going to serve me? Especially when you have a book or an article or something telling you, you can do this in X amount of days. I think we expect to all live healthy lives. One live healthy lives out beyond 30-day limit that they put on us on an article or a book or wherever you are, a commercial that tells you you can take this pill and in 30 days you'll lose 30 pounds. Don't be fooled, all right? Those are bad diets that in the long run are not healthy, and they're definitely not sustainable. It's not something you want to do day in and day out. Okay, again, talked about some of these things earlier, all right? Holidays are right around the corner, and we all like to eat a lot of those things that we generally don't eat during the year, all right? But there are decisions, and I know everybody here is not preparing the meals, so you're kind of a slave to whoever's preparing the meals. But again, portion control, and then we're talking about some of the things that will serve you better. So the stuff on the left side will serve you a whole lot better than the stuff on the right side. Same Christian play the way and don't eat. It's Thanksgiving, enjoy. But these are the type of things you just need to be conscious of. And because it's the holidays, these are the type of things you can, like I said, enjoy. Have them for what they are. But understand that if you are on any kind of track to lose weight or any kind of track to become healthier and live that healthy lifestyle, this is just that once in a blue moon type of thing. It's not the type of thing, type of eating you want to do on a regular basis. If you look at the bottom of the list, you see almost a 500 calorie difference from the left side to the right side. All right? Sometimes it's all about science. It's about calories in and calories out, and where you're getting those calories. The left side is kind of speaks for itself, but white meat when it comes to turkey, and mashed potatoes, drizzled lightly with gravy, green beans, dinner roll, cranberry sauce, pumpkin pie. These are all staples at Thanksgiving and sometimes Christmas. The right side speaks for itself, okay? Again, the same turkey, but the dark meat doesn't serve you as well. The stuffing, the candied yams, the marshmallow toppings, the cornbread, all right? Jelly cranberry and pecan pie. Those things on the right are not horrible, but they do not commit, do not lean toward healthy eating, a healthy lifestyle, all right? Again, Thanksgiving, enjoy, okay? Shake it, enjoy. You know, your parents, your family is gonna make these type of things. Just be conscious. And if you're gonna eat some of those things on the right side, be smart. Portion control. Alright? One piece of pie as opposed to three. Alright? Those type of things. Yeah, no, the head went down there. But I mean, it's okay. I mean, like I said, I'm going to enjoy my Thanksgiving just like you are. But if you are on a healthy lifestyle, on a path to become healthier, understand that this type of eating on the right side will not serve you over the long haul. We're talking about living right. Like I said, the things that we're trying to keep at bay is the diabetes, high cholesterol, the high blood pressure, okay? Which on all those things in different combinations can lead to cancer and or stroke. Things that none of us would want. And I know a lot of us have this mentality of, well, it runs in our family. Sure, you need to be the one that kind of sets the trend. Flips that trend and says, hey, I'm not claiming it, okay? Don't claim it like it's some kind of winning Powerball ticket. It's not a good thing to have. Anybody who's had it in their family and unfortunately has lost loved to it, make that a lesson to you that that's something you don't want.